Welcome to SAP Basics Training. Let us see how to log on to an SAP system using SAP Logon program. This is SAP Logon program. Double click on SAP Logon icon. You will be presented with the SAP Logon pad. This is called SAP Logon pad. In this SAP Logon pad, there is an entry called SAP NetWeaver 7.0 EHP1. Right click on that entry and click properties. So you can see the settings already given in this particular screen. Application server is the host name of this particular SAP application server. This is host name and the instance number and the system ID. You need to have these three values to create an entry in the SAP logon pad. So once you give these details here, click on OK button and come back here and double click on this particular SAP NetWeaver 7.0 EHP1, or you can click on the logon push button from here. So once you click on logon push button, you will be presented with an SAP initial screen. This is called SAP initial screen. From here you need to enter the user details, username, password and the client information and the logon language. So in this screen, client is default is 001 and the username is SAP user and the password, and the logon language default is English. You can enter EN. If you don't enter also, it will display English only. Hit enter. So once you enter there, you will be presented with SAP Easy Access screen. This is called SAP Easy Access screen. So from here you can navigate within the system using this menu. From here you can navigate to administration part, anything else. And so you can find some information from the status bar here. There is a information about your SAP system. So NPD is the system ID of the SAP system, 001 is the client of the SAP system, and NW7EHP1 is the host name of the SAP system. And if you click on this arrow mark, it will be hide, and if you click again, it will be displayed back again. And also you can use this particular arrow mark to see some more information about your SAP system. System identifier is NPD and the client number is 001 and the session number is 1. I will explain you what is this session little later. Just client is 001 and user is SAP user and the transaction is session underscore manager. In this way you can get this information from the status bar. And in the bracket there is a 1, that means this is the first session. Any user can open up to 6 sessions. That means simultaneously he can work on 6 different functions. Okay, so how to open that particular session or create a new session? From the system you can use create session tab, or you can use the button available in the standard toolbar. This toolbar is called standard toolbar, and this is menu bar, and this is application toolbar. This is application toolbar. Okay, and from the standard toolbar you can click on the creates new session button to create new session, that means second session. And you can use the same button again to create third session, same button to create fourth session, and same button to create fifth session, and same button to create sixth session. So 6 sessions are completed. If you try to create another session by clicking on that same button, what will happen? You will be presented with an information box saying that maximum number of sessions reached. That means you cannot create more sessions than 6. Okay, click continue. If you want to close each session, you can use the cross mark from here to close the session like this, or you can log out from the system using system log off. That means you will be logged out from the system entirely. That means no session will be available. If you want to log in to the system again, double click on NetWeaver 7.0 AHP1. You will be presented back with the initial screen. In the initial screen, you need to enter the same user details, and without entering EN language code also, you can enter into the system just by hitting enter, and English language only will be displayed. Okay, and now I will use navigation tools to open some function. From the tools, administration, there is a monitor. From the monitor, you can click on the system monitoring, click on user overview, double click on user overview. This is the function of user list. That means you can see all the users logged on to your system from this screen. Right now only one user is logged on, that's why you are able to see only one user. The user information is 001 client number and username and terminal, and the dialog time, session, the type is GUI. That means we have used SAP logon GUI program to enter into the system, and how many megabytes of memory is used by this particular SAP user. Okay, and the same information can be seen from status bar also. That means who is the user logged on, this is the user logged on, and the client information, and the transaction code is SM04. That means we have used menu to enter into this particular function. Instead of using menu, you can also use SM04 T code to enter into this particular function. Just for demonstration purpose, go back and hit SM04. So same screen will be displayed as we have come to this particular screen using menu. Okay, and the transaction code can be find out from system status also. See, transaction code is SM04. So in this way you can see the transaction code, you can find the transaction code of the particular function executed. Okay, and go back you can use this button, or you can use /n also, go back. And if you want to show all the T codes of all the functions at a time, like permanently, you can use extras, click on settings, click on display technical names, and click continue. That means all the functions are presented with T codes. That means directly you can see the T code of the function. That means you can use this particular T code to enter into that function from the command bar. So in this way you can navigate within the SAP system, and you can log out from the SAP system using system log off. Click yes. So click close. So that's all about in this video. So let us meet for next session, next video. Thanks.